filling in from Michael.
Exceptionally arranged so that the meeting was able to start. The only trouble is that we did not start on time because the chairperson could not arrive on time. The chairperson is a very agile person, totally fitting for the word of the day. I'm sure she would have taken every step to come on time. It is because of unprecedented things that must have happened that must have prevented her from coming on time. Otherwise, Colin was very quick to take the role, getting the baton from Mark Abbey, who filled temporarily for the role. She quickly gained control of the meeting. She was able to go through the agenda items and set the meeting in motion, proper motion. She showed her proficiency in controlling meetings by introducing each item and giving the background of each person. The control of the chairperson could have been more enhanced if the person had also repeated the timings for each section. Sometimes the timings was mentioned, sometimes I could not hear the timings. So that really gives the time limits for the speaker to come and do that role. Otherwise, we are well connected. About the use of the word agile, the word power is supposed to be used in meaningful context where it is fit. So in that respect, in replying to Colin's question whether she had overused the word, I felt sometimes it was overused for the sake of using the word. There is no need for us to use it multiple times unless the context really fits that word. Colin also had multiple roles because she also took on the role of Toastmaster, which she did very well. There was only one speaker. She was well prepared because she had the background of the speaker. She was able to enunciate that. And she gave a demonstration of the word power again and again, agile. She was very, very agile, very energetic. And that infects the people, and they also become very energetic, very, very infectious. Though Colin forgot to mention the objectives of the speech, she quickly remembered that, and she asked the speech evaluator to cover those objectives, which was well done. Evaluator one, Robert Thompson. Very clear voice, very good presence, very deep voice, and he made a very good analysis of the speech given by Elena and gave points for improvement. And then came the motion introduced by Mark Abbey. It was an innovation for this meeting. We never had motion like this. Very interesting. It allowed everybody to speak about the motion for 30 seconds. It was like another round robin hand. But generally, the motion, when we set out a motion, it has to be very clear. It is between alternatives, this or that. What is your choice? Whereas the motion was a bit overlapping. It said about the advertisement banners or how well will you use it. That is not generally used in the motion. The motion has to be very, very clear. This or that. Only between two alternatives. Nothing in between. But otherwise, it was very innovative. Table topics master, Michael Counter. Very good research, he came with preparation, he used the words, and he very slowly spoke so that everybody can understand and comprehend what is expected. And then he chose the target speaker. And he used very good strategy. If he was to select Colin, he'll be standing here, and then he'll make a demand. Very good strategy. Very soft, he explained. One point for improvement for the table topics master is not to straight away give the topic, but to explain the rules that this role has to be performed with the members up to a maximum of 1 minute and say where the lights will stop. And if you are a guest, you are only up to allowed up to 30 seconds. Those kind of rules can be said first, and then the speech can be introduced, the topics can be introduced. Odds evaluator, Mark Saint. Very good voice, great gestures, very professionally conducted. I was very pleased with that. And we made very good observations about the speakers, and he used all the time third person to the extent that he not even mentioned the speaker's name. He only said speaker. Similarly, Mark, very good observation, very good gestures, and he made a contrast in the movements between two speakers, and he admitted he was not sure whether it is okay. From that point of view, let me share my experience. I have attended so many contests, and I was given the feedback that sometimes I'm making unnecessary movements, and sometimes they say I'm not making any movements. So the movements are really have to be purposeful. If the speech, if the theme that you are conveying, if it deserves a movement, you can. Some people use movements for showing a fading of idea or theme by moving backwards as a demonstration in giving meaning to the word. Otherwise, meanings, the movement doesn't have to be all the time. It will look like pacing, it may distract. So measure your movement. If it is required, well and good. There's nothing wrong in standing and making your delivery confidently.
Oh, there you go, Melissa.
Timer. Ken Bula, very good questions. I feel the word of the day has been mentally accepted by everybody. It was a very good choice of the word for today because everybody was so energetic and enthusiastic today. Other than this, even though we started late, I think we are really finishing on time. Great work for the chairman and congratulations.